Želim vam predstaviti ekipu filma Sigurno mjesto. Molim producenticu filma Miljenku Čagalju da mi se pridruži na sceni. S nama su I glumci Snježana Sinovčić I Goran Marković. Gdje god želiš. Čekamo producenticu filma Miljenku Čogelju ili s nama u sali, kao I autora filma, reditelja, scenaristu I jednog od glumaca Juraja Lerotića. Koliko shvatam čestitke dijela ekipe koja prvi put gleda film, ih spriječavaju da su već s nama. Dajte nam koji minut, mi dajemo vama koji minut da sredite svoje utiske, jer ovaj film definitivno nije lak, iako je impresivan. Podsjetit ću nas sve da je posebna čast I privilegija, osim što ste s nama, I u činjenici da je ovo regionalna premijera filma koji je svoju premijeru, svjetsku premijeru imao vrlo nedavno na Locarno Film Festivalu. Locarno Film Festival je jedan od A festivala I posebno značajan po tome što često detektuje reditelje budućnosti, reditelj sadašnjosti, nam se upravo pridružio. Jere, hvala što si s nama I Miljenka koju smo već najavili. Čestitke još jednom za film, čestitke za nagrade, hvala vam što ste s nama. Volimo da mislimo da je Sarajevo Film Festival sigurno mjesto za regionalnu premijeru, dijelom I zbog toga što je ovo projekat koji je razvijan u okviru Cinelink Marketa, gdje je 2018. dobio I priznanje Euroimaža, što je svakako bio značajan podstrek za dalji razvoj. Ovo je jedan od dragulja našeg regiona u užem smislu riječi I naša je želja I ideja bila da ovaj razgovor bude što neposredniji samim tim I na našem jeziku. Anyways, I would like to double check if English translation is needed. Yes, then it is provided. I would kindly ask you just to sum up our answers consecutively. It's not necessary to translate every word if you are willing and able to help us. Let's try. Yeah, thank you. So I'm switching back to our language and would really like to switch. Dakle. Nadam se da ekipa neće zamjeriti ukoliko počnemo sa producenticom I vratimo se negdje u 2018. Kada je zapravo imala priliku da se prvi put upozna sa ovim projektom, da nam kaže šta su to bili razlozi koji su je privukli ovom projektu, koja su bila glavna iskušenja I šta je prethodilo ovome šta smo upravo gledali.
Dobar dan svima, hvala što ste došli, hvala na ovom divnom I toplom pljesku I nekako prijemu. Ja sam za film prvi put čula, tad nisam bila producentica tog filma, bila sam sa jednim drugim projektom na Work in Progressu sa dnevnikom Dijane Budisavljević. Jura je tad bio sa produkcijom Propeller na razvoju ovog filma. Čula sam za njega, pročitala sam sinopsis u jednom katalogu Industrija i rekla Dani, redateljici s kojom sam tad bila tu, ako bi šta radila sljedeće, a da je igrane forme, to bi bio ovaj projekt. I par godina kasnije, točnije nekad u zimu 2020. U međuvremenu je firma Propeller izašla iz projekta. U zimu 2020. moji prijatelji i kolege s kojima sam radila betonske spavače, koji su tu su, molim, Nevenka Sablić i Saša Ban, koji su nastavili s Jurajem raditi nakon što je Propeller izašao na lokacijama, na castingu, naprosto nisu dopustili da projekt stane, su došli kod mene i pitali me da li bih se ja htjela pridružiti timu i da li želim da zajedno radimo taj projekt. Dali su mi scenarij, ja sam ga pročitala i to je... Znači, na toliko razina me taj scenarij dirnuo profesionalno, pročitala sam ga i nisam vidjela jedne rečenice viška. Drugo, ja osobno imam slično iskustvo i to što sam pročitala za mene je bilo toliko točno, duboko i autentično da nisam mogla izaći uopće iz te priče. I tako da ja uopće tu nisam ono, sekunde dvojila. Tako da smo mi u zimu 2020. odlučili da snimamo 7 mjeseci kasnije po nekom prvotnom planu. Bilo nam je užasno važno da snimamo u kasno proljeće, da se vidi nabujala priroda i snaga prirode u odnosu na čovjeka i to nismo htjeli propustiti. I, tako da smo vrlo brzo fiksirali datum. I onda u jeku pandemije, iz jeku razno raznih lockdowna, mi zapravo krećemo u potragu za lokacijama. Lokacije koje ste gledali, to su autentične lokacije, bolnički prostori. Mi smo zapravo tražili rupe u lockdownima i obilazili sve bolnice po Zagrebu i tražili mjesta gdje možemo snimati. A lokacije smo gubili i nalazili doslovce na tjednoj bazi. Ono, mislili bi, aha, ok, riješili smo, sad ćemo tu probati, sad ćemo tu nekako, ono, mislit ćemo kroz taj prostor i onda bi nam javili, a ne može. Tako da cijeli tim je bio uključen u traženje lokacija. Scenografkinja Jana Plečaš, koja je isto, ja mislim, koja je tu u publici, direktor fotografije, Marko Brdar, Snježana Sinovčić, koja je pomagala. Apsolutno svi smo nekako tražili način da dođemo do onoga što smo mislili da je da taj film treba. I to se tako nastavilo zapravo kroz cijelo snimanje. Mali tim, budžet koji nije odgovarao potrebama tog filma, jer smo snimali i u Zagrebu i u Splitu i na autoputu, to sve skupa košta i zahtjevno je u smislu ljudi, tako da smo mi radili sve, ono, svi smo vozili, razvozili, igrajuće vozilo koje ste gledali u filmu je bilo vozilo koje je prevozilo ekipu kad god i god je trebalo, svi smo bili vozači, patineri i nekako se cijela ekipa koja je od početka taj projekt doživjela kao neku vrstu misije, maksimalno uključila da on bude i napravljen na onom nivou na kojem je Juraj to zamislio i na kojem je taj projekt trebao. Produkcijski tim je bio užasno mali. Lucija Buljeta i Sabina Softić su nekako meni pomagali isto tako oko svega. Teško je to sad zapravo prepričati. Izazovi su vjerojatno izazovi svakog snimanja. Ja mislim da je kod nas bilo specifično stvarno to što nas je bilo malo i što su vremena bila takva kakva jesu, pandemijska.
Hvala. Could you try to sum up, please?
Yeah, sorry. So the first time I've heard about this project, I was actually involved in some other projects that I was working on, and later I will find out that some of the other team members were also at the same time working on other things. And when I first heard about it, I said, if I was to do something next, if I was to become involved in a project after this one, that would be something that I would like to do. Fast forward to the winter 2020, apparently the there were some changes with this particular project, and I was one of the people invited to join in. I was contacted, I was presented what was done so far, what we were to do next, and I gladly accepted. I thought this project was quite a challenge for me, both professionally and personally. Professionally, there were so many things that I found intriguing about the project, but also personally, there was a personal attachment because I share some of the similar experiences with some of the things that this story is all about. So I gladly accepted to become involved, and 7 months later, we began filming. We decided to start filming in the late spring. For us, it was very important to portray this awakening of the nature versus the awakening of the human. We wanted to draw this comparison between the nature and the human. So late spring was the ideal time when we wanted to start this project, and we did. We were quite limited. There were many challenges that we had to work with. Challenges in terms of human resources, other resources, shortage of everything. And the whole team really got together, really worked together. We all scouted locations together. We used every moment in time that we could, that we went to find the locations that we thought would be ideal for this project, hospital locations primarily. However, unfortunately, the spring brought the pandemic as well. So we had to deal with that. We had to find the holes, the loopholes in the pandemic, in the working hours of the hospitals. But we did. We also served as logisticians, all of us. We all drove the van that you could see in the film, for example. So we all really got together and worked together on this project.
Amazing. Puno hvala, ovo je bilo stvarno impresivno. Juraj, ono što me zanima je kada i kako si ti pomislio da lična priča može postati film?
Pa ja zapravo nisam to, ja kad sam, nakon što se to dogodilo, ja sam zapravo bio na jedan način, mislim nakon nekog odmaka, ko uopće fasciniran da je takav užas moguć. Znači da je moguće da se desi nešto toliko, da zapravo neko koga poznaješ 30 godina, tako reći, nestane pred tobom. Jel? I ja sam to onda počeo pisati više iz refleksa. Znači, kao možda bi neko iz refleksa razbija kuću, možda bi neko sagradio kuću, a ja sam to počeo pisati, ali nekako više za sebe, tako reći. I dok sam to pisao, sam se zapravo, ima jednom su Žižeka pitali kao kako on tako puno objavljuje, onda on rekao, ma ništa, ja jednostavno dok pišem, mislim da to neću nikad objaviti. Kao, i tako si olakšao u principu, ali ja mislim da sam zapravo slično pisao taj film, nekako misleći da to nikad neću snimiti. I stalno je to nekako bilo tako, ok, sad sam to napisao, pa ću to dati nekom producentu, pa neće se to nikom svidjeti, pa kao, ajde, sad se nekome svidilo, pa će to ići kao, prijavit ćemo dobiti pare, pa nećemo dobiti pare, međutim, to je sve bilo brže. Znači, jedini sam ja sabotirao zapravo taj film na neki način. Tako da je to nekakav start u principu bio.
Ajde da dozvolimo prevod prije sljedećeg pitanja.
A, pardon. Oh, sorry.
Ne, nije problem. So for me, actually, the way I started working on this was that I started reflecting. When people reflect on things, they reflect in different ways. Some people will destroy their own house when they reflect, when they think about things. Some people will build a house. So some people are constructive versus other people who are destructive. However, for me, I reflect my views and my thoughts in more creative ways, specifically in writing. So I started
started writing things that I was feeling, that I was thinking. And when I originally heard about all this, what I was mostly thinking was, how is it even possible that something like this could happen to someone you know? How can it even be possible that someone simply disappears? And this is how it all really started for me. Now, it reminds me in a way that Slavoj Žižek once answered a question when people asked him about his creative process, where he said, the way I work is keep writing and writing and writing without ever intending to even publish it. So it was similar for me in a way. I was writing for the sake of my own creative process. I was writing thinking, okay, this will probably never even be published. And then we continued working and going through all these stages, and I was almost in a way sabotaging myself, thinking, okay, we will now do the next stage, but it will probably lead us nowhere. However, each step led to the next step, and the process started really developing and taking off as it was going through all those stages.
Dakle, jednom kada je bilo očito da, da je scenarij spreman da postane film, ti si donio još jednu neobičnu, ja bih rekla, i hrabru odluku da osim što je lična priča postala film, ti zapravo istovremeno budeš i reditelj i jedan od troje glavnih aktera. Ako se dobro sjećam, ti nemaš prethodno glumačko iskustvo. Šta te je ohrabrilo da kreneš tim putem?
Pa, mislim, što se tiče hrabrosti, ja mislim da ako nešto ima u toj traumi, kako bih rekao, malo je to dvostruko, ko s jedne strane ti nakon toga imaš osjećaj šta još uopće imati izgubiti. Ajme svačete, šta imam izgubiti zapravo nakon toga, jel? Ali s druge strane imaš i taj osjećaj šta ti uopće možeš, znači šta ja uopće mogu nakon, šta, znate, to ide iz nekakve neurotične perspektive, šta mogu ako nisam mogao spasiti svog brata, kogu god ja ne mogu spasiti, kako bih rekao, to je veće od mene. Ali to da ja glumim samog sebe je zapravo došlo iz procesa, to nije bilo tako napisano. Ja sam zapravo na početku mislio da ću od nekog drugog posuditi tijelo i glas, odnosno da će neko drugo govoriti umjesto mene, unatoč toj sceni u principu koja je autoreferencijalna. Ja sam mislio da će to funkcionirati, mada sad mislim da bi puno slabije funkcionirala. Ja? Tako da to, ali nije odluka išla iz toga. Tako da, ajde da prevedemo ovo.
So the question was on how he actually became involved and how he decided to make this important decision on the project, which is to be really present and really visible to become one of the three main actors. Now, that was not the plan from the beginning. The plan was basically to borrow, so to say, a form from someone, to borrow the body, to borrow the voice. However, the decision to show himself as one of the main protagonists was the result of this previously described creative process. It came from a lot of thinking and a lot of struggle and a lot of contemplating of coming from the place of thinking of what can I even do? Is there anything I can do? What can I lose? But what can I also, I believe, do if I was not able to save someone? What can I do now?
Exactly. I could do nothing. Odnosno. Ali onda u principu u nastavku to išlo iz procesa. U smislu je proces išao tako da bi za casting zapravo zvao glumce i onda meni se činilo da je ta atmosfera najsmislenija, da u principu ja sam sam nasuprot glumcu, ja sam naučim tekst, zamolim mi da nauče tekst, ako je scena sadrži četiri lica, štrihamo ta lica i samo su nas dvoje, tako reći. I onda u principu sam shvatio nakon nekog vremena da ja isto moram biti točan, jer ako ja na neki način, kako bih rekao, ne pazim na svoju artikulaciju, ne mogu ni glumci biti točni. Jel? Tako da sam ja počeo paziti malo šta radim sam, i onda, a nisam bio nikad u kadru. I onda zapravo kad smo gledali probe, a gledali smo probe, znači zajedno ja, najčešće Nevenka Sablić i Saša Ban, oni su kao rekli, pa kao, ono, zašto ne okreneš jedan put kameru prema sebi, kao li dobro zvučiš iz ova. I onda je to vidio i Boris i Lana koji su iz Propelera, i oni su kao isto rekli, da, pa kao, napravi to. I u koncu, na koncu, kad su to ljudi vidjeli, im se činilo točno. ja mislim, ja sam tražio onda još dugo ulogu za samog sebe, tako reći, ili za tu verziju samog sebe. I ja vjerujem da je tu bilo izvrsni glumac, a mislim da je problem bio moje slijepe pjege, da je zapravo to toliko iskustvo meni blisko, da ja na neki način nisam mogao, da sam jedino sam sebi bio točan. Ajde da to tako nekako kažem, jel?
So the next stage was actually the casting. I decided to take part in the casting myself. I learned the words, and I wanted to be very precise because I wanted to be the other actors precise. I had to be precise myself. So when we just started the casting process, I was off the camera most of the time, and we would have the dialogue. Normally, it would be myself and the other person only. And we would lead this dialogue. Then later on, as I was saying off the camera, and I was talking to my team, and they told me, as we were watching the casting, it seems kind of natural that you are there too. It seems as if you belong. So why would you not involve yourself as well? Why would you not show your face on the camera? I spoke to the production team, and they actually had the same feedback. They were also saying that it would make sense. And then as I started watching the casting, it started making sense to me because I was the one who was actually in the heart of this whole story. I was the one that actually had the inside knowledge and who was so much involved in it personally that simply it made sense for that person to be me. Now, that role was not specifically defined at that time yet. I was still searching for my own place, for even that personality that I was to portray that was not completely defined at this particular point. And it made more and more sense to me, even though there were some great actors, some really high quality actors and some good castings and interviews that we had. It simply started making more and more sense that person, that character should be portrayed by me because I was so much of this personality was actually coming from me, from what I am, from what I know and how I feel about.
Yeah, I think that maybe I even wasn't able to see how precise or how good they are because that experience is so near to me that it always, you know, looks in a way to me false. Yeah.
Mislim, možda bi se čak moglo reći da ja zapravo nisam mogao ni da budem objektivno.
da naglasimo malo.
Ne, ja sam samo htio još jednom, jer to ste preskočili, pa se mene činilo.
Hvala. Okay. Drago mi je da vas u ovom dijelu boravka u sali zabavljamo. Kako je tema castinga otvorena u prethodnom dijelu, ja bih voljela možda sad na ovom mjestu uključiti u razgovor Gorana i Snježanu, da čujemo i njihovu perspektivu, njihovo iskustvo, kako je bilo susresti se sa ovim scenarijem, kako je tekao proces priprema i šta je za vas posebno u ovom projektu. Snježana, hoćeš možda ti da počneš? Ili je Goran već spreman? Izvoli.
Pa zapravo, čim sam čuo da je Jure dobio financije za film od Havca, dotad nisam znao da on je išta slično napisao. Ja sam htio biti dio projekta na bilo kakav način, jer znam, poznavao sam njegovog brata i njega i znam da su jako talentirani i njihov zajednički film, onda vidim Tanju, je meni jedan od najboljih hrvatskih filmova do danas. I htio sam jednostavno biti na bilo koji način dio toga. Rekao sam mu, nosit ću ti bilo šta, bit ću ono šta god hoćeš, samo ono, pomagati u castingu i tako. I tako je bilo nakon nekog vremena, njemu treba uvijek malo da se ohrabri, pa je onda skupio hrabrosti da mi da taj scenarij. Ja sam ga pročitao, to je bilo normalno intenzivno. I onda je on odlučio, rekao mi je vrlo brzo nakon toga, ja mislim da misli da ja neću glumiti u filmu. Da čisto da raščistimo tu situaciju. To je bilo na aerodromu nakon što je dobio ovdje nagradu za scenarij. Onda mi je rekao da čisto eto, da pročistimo taj. Ja sam rekao dobro, sve okej, ali dalje ja ću ti pomoći. I, i onda smo nakon jedne nove godine Božića dao mi je taj scenarij i mi smo počeli čačkat zajedno kao proces nekakav casting gdje ja i dalje nisam znao hoće li biti u filmu ili ne. I to je trajalo jedno 6, ja mislim, 7 mjeseci.
Snježa da, 2 datuma.
Da, to, 7 mjeseci kad je on meni konačno rekao da bi to bio ja. U tom cijelom procesu ja sam bio zahvalan zato što je on takav, tako dobar redatelj u radu s glumcima, da je meni bilo sve jedno hoću li ja biti na kraju u filmu ili ne. Meni je svako naše druženje, ja sam osjetio kako rastem kao glumac. I bilo me strah isto tako jer sam poznavao njegovog brata kad prije uopće tog prvog susreta me strašno bilo strah šta će to biti, kako će to izgledati. No čim smo krenili, počeli smo stvarati nešto drugo od toga što zapravo je, od stvarnosti. I eto, to je to, to je nekako najveći sad, možemo dalje, ali...
So my interest in this film, in this project, was actually a carte blanche, I would say, because I was immediately interested as soon as I heard that he was involved, because I have so much respect for him, for everything that he has done. I have known his brother, I've known him, and I consider some of his artistic heritage some of the most... some of the greatest accomplishments, actually, in the Croatian cinematography. So immediately I was interested, immediately I was drawn to this project. We spoke about it right away, and he told me right away, as we clarified right now, actually, even I was hoping that I could perhaps be a part of this project, but he told me right away that I was not going to be in the film. Then some time passed, he did give me the screenplay, so I read through the screenplay, we started the screening process. It took 7 months altogether, and after 7 months he told me that he actually thought I was the one to be casted. So this was something that I was... in a way hoping for, but at the same time thinking, as I was told, that I was not going to be involved in it. However, it came to fruition after all this work that we did together. I consider Juraj an amazing director. I consider the time spent together, even the casting and everything that we did together, the talks that we did about this project, as a great learning process for myself. And I think I learned so much through all these conversations that we've had, and especially through our work together.
Zadrži mikrofon sekundu. Zanima me zašto si mislio da Goran ne može biti taj tada i kad si shvatio da u stvari treba?
Intuitivno, znači to je jedino što je kontraintuitivno, čini mi se, tu sam baš ono falija. Znači ja sam, da li je to zbog toga što su on i moj brat se stvarno toliko dobro poznavali, pa mi je to kao bilo malo nešto kao čudno, malo oko toga. A drugo nisam, kako bih rekao, ne znam vam to objasniti. Znači, činilo mi se, sve sam nekako bira po intuiciji i nekako sam, mi se činilo da štima, da mi intuicija nekako, da, to mi se činilo jednostavno, ne znam, nema. Da, na koncu sam zapravo zaključio da za tu ulogu trebam nekog ko na neki način zrači ono vitalnošću i koji možda čak ima, možda je to potpuno glupo tako razmišljali, da čak ima povijest, filmografiju zapravo oprečnu. Znači da ima fotografiju nekoga ko igra, jel? I onda nekog takvog onda zapravo srušiti u to stanje, onda zapravo na neki način taj lik postane zagonetniji. Jel? Da sam uzeo nekog tako kržljavog, ko da sam ja, ko što sam ja, ili još kržljavijeg, onda nekako to brzo nekako, kao ona ti bude jasno, ok, on tako, valjda se ona tamo drogira, pa jel, kao ono, jel, nešto takvo. Jel, tako da nekako na taj način zapravo je, to se dobavno, nisam rekao zašto, nisam znao da je Goran, ali ne znam još uvijek. Ali znači mi nakon smo probali 3 dana, ja sam nekako došao iz Zagreba, tamo sam probao s drugim ljudima, nekako smo rekli ajmo čao, dogovorili smo se 3 dana. Kao, mi se to uvijek čini kad kažeš jedna proba, ono, to je samo nervoza, onda bolje reći 3, pa onda kao nekako onako. I svakako smo se dogovorili, nakon ta 3 dana sam skužio da smo mi napravili zapravo nekakav ogromni pomak. Tako, to je nekako moja slika toga.
So the question, why did you tell him right away that he was not the one who is going to be casted in the film, and then later on you changed your mind? So the answer is, it's very hard to say, and I'm not even sure that I am able to really explain it. The fact is that I was very intuitive in everything that I was doing right from the start. However, this was one of the counterintuitive decisions that I have made. It's hard to say really why. Perhaps it comes from the fact that he really knew my brother well, and my brother used to know him well. And perhaps I think in a way I found that somehow off-putting. But then there was a lot of other things that were going through my head as I was deciding, as I was casting. It's hard to really put a finger on what made my mind finally change. I think in a way it even has to do with his stature, to start from that. If you compare my stature to his stature, of what the impression of someone thinking of that character would be. If you see me, for example, I'm smaller in stature. I am someone that people could perhaps see and simply dismiss as someone who might, who some people might assume, oh, look at him, he might be on drugs, he might be, look at the way he looks, the reason for that might be so and so. However, when you look at him, they would not have that same impression. So I think in this whole process of reaching my decision, I think I even put myself in a completely opposite direction, so to say. And I focused my mind for a moment on a character that was so completely different than what I originally thought I needed, that it, in a way, presented a challenge to me to, in a way, deconstruct that character, or that stature at least, to something that it was supposed to represent in the end. So basically, to take this whole process from one extreme to the other, to reach something that I myself was not even expected to reach. I was interviewing other people. I had casting sessions in Zagreb, and then as I was coming back, we were talking, and I said, why don't we have three more sessions, for example, because, you know, if you narrow yourself down to a single session, you are sort of time limited and feel restrained or constricted. So we settled for three, and then we had this one session, and this decision was actually, in a way, born out of that. I spontaneously realized that this was the thing to do.
Snježana, ti si za ovaj scenarij rekla da je bio ono izvrsna literatura, i to je sigurno pomoglo i želji da radiš na njemu, ali me zanima da s publikom podijeliš malo sjećanja na taj proces koji svakako nije ni tipičan ni jednostavan. Ti odaberi detalje.
Hvala puno. Dakle, Jure i ja smo imali nekakvu povijest, on je mene zvao u taj njegov film A onda vidim Tanju, kojeg ja nisam gledala, nažalost u njemu nisam ni imala priliku igrati iz nekih mojih osobnih razloga. Mama mi je bila umrla i nisam bila sposobna ništa raditi, iznenada se dogodilo. Tako da sam morala odbiti ulogu u tom filmu i zapravo smo se mi čuli samo telefonom tada. Poslije sam ga još vidjela u jednoj prilici, vrlo kratko, i nisam upamtila lice. Nakon toga, nakon ne znam koliko je godina prošlo zapravo, ne sjećam se, Jure mene zvao, ali sam ga jako dobro upamtila, što naši telefonski razgovori u vezi tog scenarija bili vrlo iscrpni. I on je onda pozvao mene u jednom trenutku, ja sam prvenstveno kazališna glumica, igram jako puno u teatru, i nazvao me da se nađemo, da on ima neki scenarij, da bi volio razgovarati o tome. Ja sam to odbila jer sam bila pred premijeru koju sam spremala, pa nisam mogla baš mozak raspodijeliti na dva kolosijeka, nisam baš brze glave. I mi smo se našli, dakle, pamtim datume, to je bio prvi ili trećeg, našli smo se u jednom kafiću i nije Jure nesiguran, što je rekao Goran, pa ne dijeli scenarij, nego Jure ne da scenarij svoj. Da, on je meni ispričao priču što on hoće raditi, dao mi je tu jednu scenu koja je mene strašno dirnula i zapravo je ja sam intuitivno poželjela to ne radit. Da. I tako smo se mi nalazili par puta. On je mene tada nagovorio da ajde, da ipak malo, naravno ja sam to njemu i artikulirala iz kojih razloga ja to ne bih. Jer sam naslutila šta se iza svega toga krije, kakav je to, mislim on mi je rekao priču, jel? Ja nisam očekivala od sebe da ću biti dovoljno čvrsta da kroz taj cijeli proces prođem. On me je naravno uspio nagovoriti. Ja sam u startu dobivala samo scene za probe koje smo mi imali u početku i tek nakon nekog vremena Jure je meni odlučio dati scenarij na čitanje. Tu je zapravo bilo jasna meni ta moja intuicija. Naime, ja se nikad ni dan danas od tog scenarija ne mogu otkloniti u profesionalni mod. Naime, ja svaki put kad se vratim tom scenariju, ja se jako emotivno involviram. Dakle, prvi put kad sam pročitala taj scenarij, ja sam, dakle, nisam mogla uopće o njemu razmišljati kao glumica, razmišljala sam kao čovjek, kao žena, kao mama. I užasno me diralo. I nisam znala da li ja zapravo u takvoj situaciji, dakle, neko ko ne može kroz scenarij proći od početka do kraja, ako bi trebao u tome igrat, a treba graditi nekakav luk lika, da li uopće ima smisla ulaziti u taj proces. Međutim, Jure i ja smo, ja sam to Juri jasno i artikulirala i odlučili smo raditi, zapravo je naš dogovor bio da taj casting traje, dakle, od 1.3. do početka 9. mjeseca, što meni nije teško. Ja nemam problem sa castingzima, nemam problem ni sa odbijanjima, nemam problem ni sa tim da me uzmu da igram. Ali vremenom sam se ja zapravo... I dok smo mi radili, Jure bi meni najavio, on, shvatili ste, živi u Zagrebu, ja živim u Splitu, on bi meni najavio da dolazi u Split, da će ostati par dana i da ćemo raditi konkretne te i te scene. Ja se nikako nisam mogla vraćati tom scenariju. Ja sam njega pročitala 3 puta, čini mi se, prije nego što smo doista počeli raditi. 3 puta i svaki put je zapravo bila ista reakcija moja. I tako smo onda zapravo radili scenu po scenu, step by step. Ja sam se sve više zaljubljivala u rad sa Jurom. Sve više smo se približavali. Svako od nas ima neka svoja iskustva. Ja sam svoje iskustvo kroz taj rad s Jurom nazvala svojom grupnom terapijom. Hoćete prevesti ovo previše?
So Jura and I, we go way back. He actually offered me a role in his previous film. I was not able to take that role because of my personal circumstances at the time, so I had to reject it. And then later on, when he started working on this film, he contacted me as well. We decided to meet, we discussed the project, and Goran was saying that Jure was not really willing to share the screenplay with him. I have to say that is not true. He is a screenplay hog. He refused to give it up, so I did not see it. He shared with me only one scene. So I read through that scene, and actually reading through the scene and talking to him created for me an outline, an idea of what this was actually all about. I was not really certain that I was the right person to play in this film. Based on what I heard, based on what I felt, based on how emotionally involved immediately I became, I did not think that I would actually be able to go through even the whole screenplay, and not even to go through the whole project, through the whole film. So this is what I said. This is what I said at first, because I truly felt that way. However, we remained in touch. We kept talking. We continued discussing the opportunities. We decided to meet, and we met first week of March. We talked more. He showed me the screenplay eventually, And we decided to start with the casting. I don't have a problem with a long casting process. I don't have a problem with the rejection. I don't have a problem with anything if it feels right. And that is actually what felt right. We decided to do the casting from March until September, to do a six-month casting, to go through the stages, through parts of the scenes, through parts of the screenplay. He lives in Zagreb, I live in Split. We would be in contact. He would contact me, call me ahead when he was to come to Split, announce his arrival, and then we would do several days of casting or several scenes or whatever whatever we phrase it as. But to go back to the decision making, when I read the screenplay, and I have to say that I only read it completely, fully, three times, I was so moved. Yes. When I first read it, I was so moved and I became so personally involved that it made my initial decision not to be the part in the project even stronger, because I was thinking, how can I act in something that I cannot even read through without being so enormously affected? How can I commit to this? But I did accept, and we did start working on this as I was explaining, in those phases, in those stages.
Svjesna sam da je ovo potpuno pogrešna dramaturgija razgovora, da Snježana nije zaokružila svoj odgovor, da nismo dali priliku Jure za zadnje riječi. Međutim, za pet minuta smo obavezni da počnemo sljedeću projekciju. Festivalski kalendar je takav i užasno mi je žao da nemamo priliku zaokružiti ovaj razgovor na način na koji smo se pripremali. Također, užasno mi je žao da nećemo imati priliku da čujemo komentare i pitanja iz publike, ali situacija je takva kakva jeste. Ja nas sve ohrabrujem da film preporučimo za večernje gledanje svima koje poznajemo i koji mislimo da bi voljeli ovaj film. Zahvaljujem se ekipi što je s nama, zahvaljujem se što će i večeras biti s nama i u njihovo ime nudim opciju da tokom boravka ovdje porazgovaraju u neposrednom kontaktu, u nekom manje formalnom settingu. Još jednom oprostite i hvala vam što ste bili s nama.